Hi, I'm Jessica. Welcome back to my channel. If you've never seen a video of mine, hi, hello. I'm Jessica. I do TVs, movies, reactions apparently. And I do grocery hauls. I do grocery hauls and I remember to do the grocery haul. So pay no attention to that. And I also do put up cooking videos of what I make my kids for dinner. But anyways, now we're introduced. Hello. I have not done this type of video in a minute where I'm just like, all right. So I was online looking at something else. I was catching up on like bad boys of Texas drama. And I keep seeing like pictures, well, people's thumbnails of Amber Lynn crying. And I'm just like, what the fuck? And then I finally clicked on her video. And first of all, in all honesty, I thought this was just a regular one of her videos because she always be like, oh, excuse me, guys, I just woke up. So she always looked like that.
It was mutual. I have my freaking headphone thing in. It was mutual and... like, I'm wearing the same thing I was wearing yesterday. Like, I did have makeup. Like, I have credit all off completely. I can't stop crying. I feel like I'm mourning, like, a death. Like, knowing that one day, like, I'm just gonna wake up and she's not there. It's a different type of pain because, like, I envisioned my whole future with her. And I know she did the same, and this was mutual.
I don't like how she compared it to a death. That is just still kind of bothering me, so I just wanted to pop in and say that. Did not know going into this video what I was going to see. So apparently her and Feline have broken up. I feel bad that she got broken up with, but not bad about her getting broken up with. I don't know. I feel bad for people. Like, I don't think no one should have to go through a breakup. But then again, it makes you stronger and you do learn from certain mistakes. But in Amber's case, she does not, because it is the same routine. And I think she realized that she can't move in with nobody because she was there first. Like, somebody moved in with her. They weren't like, I think she was already in that apartment. And also, FYI, God don't like ugly, because if I was correct, wasn't Becky up in there living with you? And then you did Becky dirty, and then Becky had to leave, and this lady is eating cereal out of like a Cool Whip bowl, I think it was, I don't know. And she was doing really, really bad. God don't like ugly. So what you do to people, it come back to you. It might not come back on how you did it to them, but baby, it come back to you. So always make sure that you have good karma in the world. But also, I think it's kind of funny how Feline had so many opportunities to break up with this woman. I mean, you could have broke up with her on Juneteenth. Everybody would understand. If you know, you know. And you could have broke up on this whole 4th of July. But you...
So, Feline broke up with this girl on 4th of July. She was saying that it was over when fireworks started happening. So, yeah, she did break up with Amber on 4th of July. I mean, damn. Shit, that's bad.
Did not. And I think, like, a couple of days ago, she did say that, you know, she's no longer doing the, she's not going to do the weight loss surgery. And I find it funny around, what, 48 hours later, you get dumped? My thing is, Amber always have to have someone. She always has to be with someone. She can't never be by herself. And I really, really hope that this bitch don't have another girl on standby waiting to move all in, because she does not know how to be an adult or be a grown ass adult. She always has to depend on someone. And I really hope it's not people going to be like, oh yeah, because she was in the foster care system. No, that's not how that shit work, okay? Yes, some people that were in the foster care system as children, as infants, and have been they're in their adolescence, you know, they really don't have people to depend on. Or they go through this where they have this, like, this badge or like a wall up saying like, okay, I can't depend on these people that was in my life, these people that are supposed to help me, these people that just wanted me for a check. Now I have to put my big panties on, my big drawers on, and do what I gotta do for me. Because can't, not everyone always gonna be there to pull you out of certain situations. This girl is talking about she could picture her life with her. And honestly, it's not that you saw yourself with Feline. And honestly, I really want to know how Feline was just not letting this bitch just do certain things. And it didn't, like, you, it was so many things that, like, I'm still, the African Black History Museum, bitch, no. And you were laughing and you had the chain. No, there's certain things that was, that she pulled that I was just not cool with. But I think Feline honestly did not want to be her caregiver. And I think Feline knew that she was not, Feline, Jay, Wifey, whatever her name is. I feel like she saw, like, this girl was not going to change. This girl was, didn't want to do anything for herself. She didn't want to move forward. She still wants to be in that same position. And I think that's kind of ultimately how they broke up. Because this girl's talking about, oh my God, it was neutral. The way you crying, it was not neutral. She packed up her shit and she bounced. And they said, like, Feline wants to travel. And I think Feline was from New York. I'm guessing she's from New York, because Amber at a time kept saying, oh yeah, like, she wants to go to New York, she wants to go to New York. You're not basically going nowhere, and you always want to stay in the house, and you don't want to go here, you don't want to go there. And there are big people that I see that drive. So her talking about, oh no, she doesn't want to go, she doesn't want to drive, that she's too big. There are big people that are bigger than her that be driving. When I go to Walmart, I be seeing people out there driving, and I'm just like, what the fuck? And I am struggling to drive. But there are people that get up and do what they have to do. Even the motherfuckers that have enablers, that they want people to take care of them, they still get their ass up and they do what they gotta do. She's so dependent on people and dependent on other girlfriends that she is in this set way where this person has to cook for her, this person has to do this for her. And I think these past women get sick of it. And I think Feline actually probably told her about herself during a conversation, and is, because Feline Black. And I'm pretty sure Amber probably told her, like, baby, can you do this for me? And Feline was like, no, bitch, I ain't fucking doing this. I'm fucking sick of this bullshit. If you ever date somebody Black, you know what I'm talking about. Or if you have that one Latino partner that you just ask them to do something, and next thing you know, y'all dead ass broken up and they start taking shit. That's just how in my head I imagine it. And also, my brother and his ex, they used to have, like, the most weirdest ass arguments. It'd be so weird. Maybe in the kitchen, and he'd just be like, I'm sick of this. And he walks out. My brother has been like that, like, all his life. Even if we, like, ask him something, he just get mad. He'd be like, yeah, I'm sick of this. And he just walks out. I don't know why. And I feel really, really bad that I just imitated this man. But I'm so happy. I don't think he is watching. He does not watch these videos anyway, so I don't give a shit. But, yeah. There's, and I think somebody was saying that Feline was poly, like, Feline was dating dudes. I just thought Feline was a stud. I just thought she was a stud. Cause every time we see Feline, we really don't even see her. We just see, like, shorts or shorts. We see, like, a short sleeve shirt and, like, she's showing off tattoos, or we see her shorts with the kicks. So, I just always thought that she was, like, a stud. That's what I thought in my head. But I could be wrong. There are some dudes that be like, that date chicks that want to hang out with, like they the homie. I have no idea. And then Amber Lynn all of a sudden was talking about that she's interested in guys and she wants to date guys. What? I don't know. But when you kind of think about it, she does kind of have a type, like the way her exes kind of, they got the same like type of outfit flow, if that makes sense. Like they always, I don't know, just gotta say. But I really do hope that she gets her shit together and is able to stand on her own and do things for herself. Like, and she's like, yeah, this time I need to be by myself. I'm gonna be single for a while. But I call bullshit on that part, because she always needs someone to do something for her. This girl cannot do anything for herself. And I think that is kind of what's the word I'm looking for? I think that is kind of like a Stockholm, not Stockholm, but like, what's the word I'm looking for? It's like, she needs that, like, because she didn't have that family or she didn't have people to rely on. Whenever she gets into a relationship, I don't really think it's love. I think it's just that weird ass codependency that she wants someone here. And in her mind, it's like, I need this person. I need this person. I need this person. I need this person. I need this person to be here. This person's gonna be here. In my mind, I'm saying this, all I can hear is, Curtis, you were supposed to love me. Kind of like that. If you've ever seen Dreamgirls, you would understand. But
Effie, Curtis was supposed to
love me. Curtis was supposed to love me.
I'm sorry. I bring it back. I really honestly hope that this breakup works out for the better and not the worst, because I know she has like a whole lot of situations and
I know she did the same, and this was mutual. There has, like, I'm gonna speak for myself, my whole future with her, and I know she did the same, and this was mutual. There has been some things that just, like, I don't have to go into detail. Love just isn't enough sometimes, and I know there's probably going to be a lot of people questioning and saying you seemed so happy, and yeah, like the relationship I had with Feline was personal and we both have our own reasons, but she's my other half of my heart and I'm the other half of hers.
Really hope that it does not turn out to where she is binge eating and stuff like that, because she actually has a binge eating problem, not like foodie booties fake shit. And also another thing, if Amber had like friends, like, you know, girlfriends, like that good girlfriends that will come over to your house with the food, with the snacks, and, you know, the lighter fluid, and take your girl outside and start burning your ex's shit. I love my best friend. But yeah, because she's on, and she's saying like it's a video diary, and I understand it's a video diary, but why the fuck would you want to record when you got broken up with? But if she had like a good group of friends, a good solid group of friends, and she's not making friends through her exes, friends, because technically those aren't your friends, those are your ex's friends, sometimes you might get like a couple out of that group that was friends with your ex, and you know their loyalty is to the ex, it's not to you. But if she did have that set of friends, like that set of good, like good girlfriends, like that sisterhood, even not even a sisterhood, like a brotherhood, or like a group of friends, shit, even your mama. Because there's times that I have been through some shit and my mama was my sidekick.
Amber did say that when it happened, she did call her mom and she just cried to her mom. But it's over the phone. I don't know if her mom's like in the same state as her.
Just someone you can just vent to and just let it all out. I think that would be good for her. But since she really doesn't have friends like that, she's a hermit. She stays in the house and order McDonald's. Matter of fact, listen here. I feel like at this point, as much as she orders McDonald's and them Diet Cokes, she should be able to call up McDonald's and be like, listen here, bitch, this is what's going on. While she's placing her order and she's just going off when she's placing her order. I know that because I've done that bullshit before. I've done it before. And sometimes you get that cashier that understands your problems. And sometimes they might hook you up with some food. But I ain't gonna lie, I've done that bullshit before. That I was so pissed off. And I went to order some food. And but the cashier was like really cool. She was dope. I still even see this lady from time to time, even though she does not work at that place anymore. But yeah, so sometimes you might get that person that will want to be a listening ear, but I do feel bad for her. It is kind of sad that she's sitting up here crying, but a part of me is just like, if you are independent. And I don't mean money-wise. I mean independent of getting your fucking ass up, going outside, doing what you gotta do. And you don't have to worry, wait for the next person that has a car. Or fuck that. Bitch, call Uber. You make all this fucking money, bitch, call a Uber. If you can Uber Eats, you can Uber a ride to go somewhere. And not stay in the fucking house. And like, you have laundry and it's crazy piled in the fucking closet. It's always a fucking closet clean out. I feel like if she was more get up and go, more independent, more she can do this and show that, hey, bitch, I don't need you. Like, you need me. And she can stand on her own. Then maybe they... But then again, I can't even say that because we don't know what goes on behind closed doors. And word on the street is this bitch got a nasty-ass attitude, a nasty-ass disposition. And I've seen, like, how she was nasty to, like, Becky's mom and, you know, Destiny's mom. Like, fuck! And ain't nothing about that? Well, no, Destiny's mom did fight her. But, that's your mother. I'm sorry. But I do feel like, oh! And then the sad thing is, like, since Feline is really not on the internet, she can't really pop off. Like, I don't know. But maybe she will pop off. Who knows? I mean, Destiny out here. This bitch is pushing Becky to a point where Becky already said a little bit of stuff and it said enough. So maybe. I don't know. But then I heard like Becky was like in the comments saying that she feels bad for her or I don't know. But and some of the comments that I have read on other people's videos, people are flaming this girl. People are flaming her. And I'm just like, shit. But in all hindsight, they're not telling no lies. They're not telling no lies. And it's really sad. And I really hope this girl 2 weeks later or tomorrow don't talk about she got a girlfriend. Now, people are like, oh, Feline gonna come back. Now, I don't know. But I have no idea. But when a woman is fed up, she fed up. But then again, it might be a different situation, but I don't know. I have no idea. But that's all I have. I really don't have nothing else. I might do a foodie booty video or a dog dirty dozen video. I don't know, but it did feel good to like just like, you know, chop it up real quick. But nope, my ass got groceries I gotta put away. But I will definitely see you in my next video. And if you haven't, like, check out my other videos. Like, yeah, I have some shorts. Most of them are just me fucking cooking shit. But yeah, so I will check you in the, now how many times I'm gonna say that? Apparently this damn thing keeps telling me, the analytics keeps telling me to say, like, comment, and subscribe. So I said it. I hope you have a wonderful night, and I will see you in my next one. Myself, but I just can't get over you, girl.